Another day, another crazy story about Star Wars The Mandalorian Season 2. Katee Sackhoff is confirmed to play Bo-Katan. Holy freaking crap. Let's break this down. What's up, everybody? It's Josh. Welcome back to the channel. Smash that like button like you're trying to solidify your new empire.
Your new empire.
And let's get right into this video. So Peter Scaretta over from Slash Films has another exclusive when it comes to The Mandalorian Season 2. Peter is, of course, the person that first broke the news that Rosario Dawson was going to be playing a live-action Ahsoka Tano. And now he has scooped that Katee Sackhoff will indeed be playing Bo-Katan, the character of which she voiced in the Clone Wars and in Star Wars Rebels, and she will be portraying that in live action in The Mandalorian Season 2. Now, a couple other crazy things that are in this article, and I do recommend you go check out the article over on Slash Film just to get all the deets. It's a pretty cool article, but one of the things that's mentioned is the fact that they know that Katee actually filmed her stuff in February. Right before everything got locked down, she was able to film her scenes in February. Also, it is important to note that there will be no delay with The Mandalorian Season 2. We talked about this on the morning stream earlier today on our live streaming channel, but yes, indeed, The Mandalorian Season 2 will not be affected by all the delays going on in the world and will hit its release date in October. Holy crap, we're going to get it on time. It's got Boba, it's got Ahsoka, it's got Rex, it's got Bo-Katan. Holy crap, guys. Mando Season 2 is going to be absolutely nuts. Now, this is not as crazy as the Ahsoka news or even the Boba Fett news, because some people had speculated about this for a long, long time. Apparently, there were big rumors that she was attached to be in Season 2, and because she already voices the character, it just totally makes sense that she was going to play Bo-Katan, but now we know for sure. And I think this is great for the show and great for Katee because, again, she's already portrayed the character. She'll probably have a really easy time portraying the character in The Mandalorian and in live action. And Katee Sackhoff is a fan favorite, man. She is from Battlestar Galactica. She's done a bunch of little nerdy things here and there throughout the years. People love Katee Sackhoff, so it's awesome that she joins the Mandalorian family. Now, a couple of things I want to speculate about here. First of all, this is kind of bittersweet in a way. It makes me really feel for Ashley Eckstein, who, of course, voiced Ahsoka Tano in the show, in the animated shows, but she was not actually picked to be the person to portray that character in live action. Rosario Dawson, I think, is a better pick. She has more of the physicality. She just is a little bit more Jedi-like, and just she'll do a good job. But it is kind of weird that, like, they bring in Katee Sackhoff, but I think you can understand why. I mean, look at this side-by-side here. Like, Katee Sackhoff totally looks like Bo-Katan, and she also just is a badass. She has a history of being physical in a lot of her roles, so it just makes a lot of sense. I'm not saying Ashley Eckstein couldn't do it, but I think that's the big difference between someone like Eckstein and someone like Sackoff. Sackoff not only has a lot more live action experience, but has been way more physical in the roles that she has had. And the other place we absolutely have to go here is all about the Dark Saber and the story. Guys, I've said this before, but maybe you haven't fully paid attention to how big of a deal this is. The last time we saw the Darksaber before Moff Gideon cut himself out of that TIE fighter was when Sabine Wren was handing it to Bo-Katan and making Bo-Katan realize that she was going to be the now rightful ruler of Mandalore. This was a big freaking deal. Bo-Katan is the rightful ruler of Mandalore. She's the last person to have the Darksaber. Obviously, Moff Gideon took that Darksaber from her. Now, look, here's where my thought process is with this. If Katee Sackhoff filmed her stuff in February, that feels like it's pretty late into the filming for Mando Season 2, so maybe it's not the biggest role, and maybe that role will take place late in the season. As we know right now, Ahsoka, Sabine, and Rex are only going to be in one episode. Now, we don't know for sure if Boba Fett's only going to be in one episode, but we know he's having a limited role. I think we can assume the same thing with Katee Sackhoff. I think she's playing a minor role, but we just found out yesterday that Boba Fett is actually going to have his role expanded in Season 3, that he will be a big part of the story in Season 3. Well, what if Katee Sackhoff and Bo-Katan are also a big part of Season 3? And this kind of led me to this thinking of how this could all tie together. What if the Mandalorian, or Din Djarin, goes to Mandalore towards the end of the show, and he's there where Bo-Katan, Rex, Ahsoka, and Sabine are all there, but Sabine, Ahsoka, and Rex are actually about to head off to go find Ezra Bridger, right? So they're about to go do that, Well, the Mandalorian meets them. They have some kind of interaction there. They leave, but then Bo-Katan is there. And then in season three, we set up more stuff on actual Mandalore with Moff Gideon. It's just a thought. I don't know anything more than just speculating about that. There's all sorts of different ways that this could go. But regardless, the big thing here is, of course, that Katee Sackhoff's Bo-Katan is the rightful ruler of Mandalore. And I just see that that's where it's going, man. I talked yesterday about how I think that we could be getting a lot of Kamino stuff with Boba. The connection between the child and Kamino and Boba and Kamino is very obvious. But, you know, the more I think about it, the show is called The Mandalorian. So perhaps Boba and Bo-Katan and the Mandalorian and Din Djarin are all going to have a big focus on Mandalore itself in season three. That would be really interesting. And of course, the Dark Saber plays a big role in that, right? So crazy stuff. I'm super excited. I'm sure you're excited too. Let us know your thoughts about Katee Sackhoff coming to the Mandalorian season two in the comment section below. And now let's shout out Wyatt Trost. Yes, indeed, the model of ship that Boba Fett uses is the Fire Spray. So shout out to you, Wyatt. Now let's ask another nerd card question before we get out of here. I want to know, what is the in-universe name for coffee in Star Wars? It has a unique name in Star Wars. What's the Star Wars name for coffee? Answer that question in the comment section below. If you absolutely need more nerdy content in your life, click or tap over there to watch some more of our content, or come on by our live streaming channel where we stream every day, Monday through Friday, starting at 10 a.m. Eastern Standard Time. Like this video if you liked it, or if you want to take your support to the next level and join the list of amazing people you see below, check out our Patreon for some behind-the-scenes content. As I always say, I hope you're having an awesome and a nerdy day, and I'll see you in the next video.